Parade Day, a chance for the University of New South Wales Sunswift team to show onlookers just how sexy a solar car can be. But with the World Solar Challenge 2 weeks away, Eve's first high-speed test tomorrow, and departure for the race the day after, there is tension in the air. It's just one of many late nights at the workshop, and engineering students work with what they've got. Carbonara with chopsticks is fuel for the hours of labour ahead. For 2 years, Sunswift have been preparing Eve for her race from Darwin to Adelaide.
It means that almost everyone here has been putting in at least 10, 15, 20 hours a week more when times get stressful or something's due.
Yet these 60 students volunteer their time towards this world-class project.
It's the first time you really get a chance to apply all the things you learn to something real, and the thing that you're getting to apply it to is really, really cool. And it's something that tends to inspire them, something that tends to drive them, and the chance to work on something like that and to use that as a chance to hone your skills is just kind of incredible.
And here's the payoff. Weighing only 300 kilograms, this carbon fibre cruiser can hit a top speed of 140 kilometres an hour using highly efficient solar cells. At the same time, it uses less electricity than the average household toaster.
So the design concept behind Sunswift Eve is to make a car that looks like an actual car. Previously solar cars have been flat. Now this car looks like a real car. It's got four wheels, two doors, two seats, proper windscreens and proper visibility.
It's been a bumpy road. 43 design revisions later, this sports car is light enough to be a contender in the race. Wing mirrors have been replaced with a camera. Wheels have been covered to reduce turbulence. And without an engine, a tunnel has been cut out from her base to increase airflow. But with such speed comes great responsibility. These students carry the burden of keeping the driver safe.
While falling behind on uni work is pretty stressful, given that it's your degree, it's nowhere near as stressful as the thought of getting something wrong on this car is. Almost every person on the mech team is in charge of one component that goes on the car. We do everything we can because just the consequences are ridiculous.
From the 6th of October, their hard work will be put to the test in a grueling race across the outback.
Strong winds, oncoming road trains and potential bushfires are just some of the obstacles that Eve will face in her upcoming journey. All things considered, it's quite a relief that she has reclined seating and plenty of elbow room, unlike her predecessor, Ivy.
Whatever the outcome of the race, it's certain that Eve will inspire the next generation of Australian solar car engineers. Joan Henson, reported Jonline.